This is Frabe College, the first university in sub-Saharan Africa. It was originally established on the 28th February 1827 by Christian Missionary Society as an institution for training catechists. Since its existence, it has become one of the leading universities in Africa where students from other countries came to acquire education. Thus, it has produced prominent personalities both nationally and internationally. It was as a result of its solid educational foundation that it was referred to as the Athens of West Africa. Among the many things that have over the years contributed to the development of the college is its conducive learning environment, of which the hostels cannot be excluded. Hostels at FBC have great importance in the educational journey of students. Upon its reopening, these hostels, which were closed down for almost a decade, have also trained male students as their female counterparts how to do domestic chores, interact with fellow students, and also increase their studies. For some time, students were unable to make use of the hostels because of the facilities' poor and challenging conditions. Thankfully, Sierra Estate Management Company, together with Frabe College Administration, decided to refurbish and manage the facility.
With regards to the hostel, it's a big by Frabe College Administration. We all know the hostels have been built by mobile companies now. And because of our expertise in property management, we're able to work in the building process. And we look at it that this is a new area we're coming in, managing our hostels for the very first time. Based on our experience in property management, we're going to be that educational institution, we want to come for new roles in managing.
For the limited number of students who are presently occupying some of the hostels, their moments have been very exceptional as they feel independent, academically motivated, and relieved from transportation constraints.
No, it lessens the body because of transportation and also some environment out there not conducive for studying. The noise out there is too much. So for here, I think the place is cool, somehow accommodating and encouraging, and we can be able to study, we have the perfect decor and so on.
It's comfortable as hostel here. We're really enjoying the hostel management due to the SAMCO arrangement with the FPC management. SAMCO.
Well, I wanted a new surrounding and I wanted to be closer to the hostels. That's basically it. I would say getting along with different people from different backgrounds, because like I didn't live with lots of people, so like when I'm here I'm getting to know different people. And also in terms of studies, the environment is much more peaceful and accommodating, and I have people from my class that I can study with.
It's exceptional, as you're saying, because there are so many challenges when you live far away from campus, and the emergence of the hostel has brought so many advantages to us residing here presently, because it's exceptional in years, considering that it helps in development of ourselves in the programs we do.
Being on campus, there are so many advantages here, because if you're a very good student, you study on the campus, first and foremost, you have ample time to read. You have a focused mindset. Unlike if you're downtown, you'll be distracted with so many activities. But if I'm on campus, lights are available, assuming I'm reading, then I want to do research, I can easily go to the Wi-Fi, connect my computer, and do the basic which I want to do. So that would be one of the advantages of being on campus. Two, if I want to be on campus, the reason why I'm on campus is the fact that when the exam is very close, of course, you know the challenges students are facing regarding transport. You have to cover a journey and where you came, maybe you're aspiring, all this kind of thing. But if I'm on campus, as I'm coming on campus, all those things, these are things I will not go through them again.
In spite of the appreciable moments students are faced with, they also encounter challenges along the line. Those challenges range from inadequate water supply, security threats, to poor peer group influence.
Water. The water facility has been the greatest challenge we've faced ever since we came here. And also, not all the time, but when we have riots, we faced it the most, like for this past election that took place on the second. Yes, we are greatly disturbed anyway. But apart from that, the hostel is good, we are okay.
Challenges, I would say, for now, the main challenge we are having was that of water. It's okay now. You don't have challenge. I'm not sure if you have challenge for
water. Well, the challenges, I'll say two basically. One is water, because the water is really short here. We have to like fetch it. It's more exhausting and take up a lot of time. And I also say like security wise, because there are not lots more of security. Because the last time when we had a little bit of riot during the election, like the security had to go and leave us all alone here. So yeah, they need more security.
That we have been faced with monumental challenges, great challenges so far. You know, at times I have to come here at home. So that I did the camp or go down there to even get my clothes longer. The key aspect, the major challenges of which maybe I will give you the university, the admin will come with the access to view this thing is the water situation. As you speak, there's no water. If you're interested in that, we have to use such as water to even have our bath just to maintain ourselves. I've got to pull to work, the longer I close, I have to go downtown. You know, it takes a week or so to get some water. You know, even lecturers, most of our colleagues. So that's a very key aspect of being on campus. Another issue is security threat. So when we are here, we find it very difficult. Everyone is lonely. The security that are being employed to guide the hostel, they are not around. So we are not being secure. The environment is very poor.
As it stands, there are less than 60 students occupying the hostels, and only few blocks are in operations at the moment. This is because the beds in the blocks are not enough to accommodate the growing number of students. Hostels life at FBC has both its merit and demerit.
To operate a student hostel, especially at the college, must have some challenges. And you did mention about the water, which is very, very true. Initially, with the power arrangement or the arrangement that have between my home college administration is the administration had to provide water and security. Those two key things should be provided by the public college administration. When we took over, we are having this so much pressure about letting students use the hostel, so we decided to start functioning. And initially we start receiving water from the public college administration of the reservoir there, but it was having problems with the dam also.
Undoubtedly, the former surpasses the latter.
But the primary challenge at Frabe College that contributes enormously to the destruction of the facilities on campus is frequent violence during student union elections. The ad on the reputation of Frabe College is gradually being shattered, and its property have been vandalized by some miscreants who pass for students. Such situation is found out by some other students on campus.
Actually, from my own perspective, I think one of the key reasons responsible for the high rate of violence on campus, I think it has to do with the attitude of the students themselves. Even though the administration have their own part, but actually, I want to look at it from the area of the students themselves, because there is this belief, there is this proverb which says, before ever you talk to the door, you have to talk to the bone as well. So I think the students also have a great role to play. Many of us as students, we are not responsible, first of all. We are not responsible. I remember there was a time when they asked some students out of the classroom because they are yet to pay their school fees. We see a lot of students on campus, they are throwing stones, destroying properties that are meant to benefit other students. So I think if actually we want to reduce or, you know, put to an end the rate of violence on campus, we need to change the mindset of students. The mindset of students on campus here is really corrupted. I think that is one of the key reasons responsible for the high rate of violence on campus, the attitude of students.
I think the constraints are coming from the administrative themselves and the SU presently, the SU government, because first to start with, during the election. I think the administrative selected, because I don't call it the election, they selected the political party that should run in the campus. Like, for example, the Bona government, it was not clearly elected because there was some chaos among students about who and what or whatever. So I think the administrative take upon themselves and restore the power to Bona because they think it's like that. So the whole problem started from there. And all this chaos, all this violence that's been going on, and I think yesterday I saw like 4 trucks of police. I thought they said they're rioting or whatsoever. Hadn't been the administration will have allowed the students to elect their own president or their own government willingly, I don't think all this violence and all this chaos will be going about. So I think the problem is coming from the administrative.
Well, for my own instance, I could say it is because they are the law, they are initiating law, and the national advocacy. Because if you look at it, it is our right to actually have access to college education and to take our exams. But it is also our duty to pay our fees, right? But if the students are being asked out of the exam, they could have mobilized in a very peaceful way and negotiated with administration for them so that they could sit together and see what we can bring to them. But they failed to do so and decided to take them in their hands. So I believe normally we have riots in campus due to the ignorance of the administrative laws and the ignorance of the national laws.
In spite of the challenges befalling the university and its students, Fabre College still maintains international standards.